Fourscore and 165 years ago, our forefathers brought forth on this continent a new nation. But on a real note, when I say overachiever, what comes to mind? Webster's Dictionary defines it as a noun, one who achieves success over and above the standard or expected level, especially at an early age. Welcome to my world. I'm number 5 in a family of 6. As long as I can remember, the bar has been set pretty high. Both of my parents have master's degrees and have been very successful in their careers. At age 14, my brother was involved in an accident where he almost lost his leg and had to learn to walk again. He still graduated high school with a 3.4 GPA, learned to walk, and even wrestle less than 9 months after the accident. My sister, on the other hand, went above and beyond, graduating with a 4.29 GPA. She was a member of FBLA, qualifying for nationals all 4 years of high school with a 5th place at the National Leadership Conference in 2016. She amassed over 2,000 hours of community service, working to improve the lives of those in our community. She raised money and spearheaded projects for homeless teens, DUI awareness, water safety, and the importance of budgeting and saving. But I didn't come here to talk about my sister. Hi. My name is Tim Haley, and I'm here today to talk about how I plan to raise the bar even higher and set an example for my younger brother, fellow FBLA members, and those to come. One of the 8 FBLA PBL goals is assisting students in the establishment of occupational goals. This year, I plan to run for regional vice president, next year state president, and national president by my junior and senior year. Now, you're probably wondering how FBLA and goal setting is going to help me in the future. According to the website raise.me, more than 300 colleges offer up to $10,000 in scholarships for each year of FBLA. When I graduate high school, my goal is to go to college to become an anesthesiologist. To become an anesthesiologist, it takes 4 years of undergraduate study, 4 years of medical school, and 4 years of residency. FBLA has taught me to have high goals for yourself. I joined FBLA in the 7th grade, and I had set goals to meet the deadlines for competing at regionals, state, and nationals. I set goals to become FBLA national president by my senior year. Prior to FBLA, I had always been a fly-by-the-seat-of-my-pants kind of person. I have a list of goals for my high school career in FBLA. This practice of goal setting will help me excel through the 12 years it takes to become an anesthesiologist. My college goals will transition to occupational goals, which will drive my career trajectory. I can attribute this goal mindset to the habits that I built in FBLA. I'm excited about the future, and if I reach half of my goals I have set, well then, watch out. I started my speech with the opening line of the Gettysburg Address. I'm sure you recognize it. Our 16th president, Abraham Lincoln, had goals. He wanted to end slavery, unite this country. In his inauguration speech in 1865, he spoke these words regarding the need to reconstruct the South and reunite the Union. With malice towards none, with charity for all. Thank you.